Ouais,
ouais, ouais, fille, ouais.
Good morning, I just woke up here in my tent at the Sand Fire Roadhouse where I had a pretty good night. Today I'm doing 290 kilometers to Port Hedland. Now you know that 290 is not doable with my car, but today it is. And it is mainly thanks to the Australian Electric Vehicle Association and the Tesla Owners Club of Australia. They have been installing charging stations all around Australia, and today I can do 150 kilometers to the Pardoo Roadhouse, where I can charge up with three-phase, which takes only 4 or 5 hours. And then I can make it to Port Hedland. So thanks to their network, I can cover 400 kilometers a day. I arrived in Port Hedland. I'm now at Laura's house. I haven't met her. I was texting with her. She said, if you make it before 6:30, then you can come with us to have dinner at our friends. But yeah, the sunset was so beautiful, so I stopped to take some pictures. She said, if you don't make it on time, we'll leave you the key and just go into her house and sort yourself out. And I still find it really special that people who don't know me, don't know anything about me, I never met them before, they just give me the key and let me into the house. Yeah, you know, I can steal something, but I cannot make it far anyway with that slow car. Somehow I forgot to feature Laura in this video, but for those of you dying to see her, this is my great host. Cool. I am here in South Hedland with Dan. Dan sent me a message on my website. He said, yeah, I'm the only electric car driver in the Pilbara, and he owns a DIY electric car also.
Hello.
Hi Dan.
Hello.
What's the story about this car?
So it's a Ford Focus Convert.
Yeah.
So it's approximately same age, it's about done in 2010.
Yeah.
It's part of a University of Western Australia project. So yeah, it's 180 volts. It's got a warp traction motor on it. Has a range of approximately 150 kilometers. Yeah, that's charges on 10 amps and been my daily driver for quite a few years now.
Yeah? You drove it all around Australia?
No, not quite that far. No.
Oh shit, okay.
Although maybe you've inspired me to go Karratha.
Yeah? Okay. Which is the next place, that's about 230 km from here.
Yep.
Yeah. Alright, and yeah, so it's a Ford Focus from the outside. What can we see here?
So we have a battery charger, a motor controller, vacuum pump, a DC-DC converter to create 180 volts down to 12 volts. We have the interlocking system there, one of the 6 battery packs in the car down here, and obviously the main drive motor connected to the stock transmission. Also the air conditioner is also connected up to the main drive motor as well, so the original stock air conditioning is still intact.
Okay. In this car. What kind of batteries are inside?
ThunderSky 200 amp hour.
Okay.
Lithium iron phosphate batteries.
Total capacity?
Total capacity is approximately, I think it's 26 kilowatt hours. Okay. It's 180 volts, 200 amp hours.
Yeah, yesterday I left Laura's place and I went to somewhere else in all the way to the south of Hedland. It was about 20 km from Port Hedland.
15 km, everyone.
Stayed with Joe.
Hi.
Joe, tell me about turtles.
Turtles are really cool. We have flatbacks, flatback turtles in Hedland, and they come up every year and they nest.
And what? Okay. And what do you do with them? Because you're a turtle rescue girl.
Yep, that's me. Yeah. We monitor them, so we'll like measure them and check their flipper tag number and their pit tag number, like a microchip, like a cat or a dog. So
okay.
We can see how often they come to the beach and if they're, you know, coming back really often every year or every few years, and see how long they live for and that sort of thing. So just build up a big data set which goes towards WA's sea turtle project.
Okay.
So
cool. Thanks for letting me stay. I don't have so much footage because that's where because we went party yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
footy party.
I forgot my camera, and it was good for once. I needed that. Good party.
See some people.
Yeah. So thanks.
Thanks.
All the best.
Good luck with the rest.
Yeah, thanks.
I left Port Hedland and I wanted to go to Karata today. That's 230 km, and yeah, I'm now charging in the middle, exactly in the middle at a pub. And I think it's so amazing. It's 110 km to Port Hedland, 120 to Karata, and between there is just fucking nothing, except for this pub. There's just a pub in the middle of nowhere, and they have an official AEVA, Australian Electric Vehicle Association, charging spot. This is why I love Australia. It's so great.
Set my heart at ease. Gonna make a sentimental journey to renew old memories. Got my bag, got my reservation. Spent each dime I could.
On the first day of the trip in Australia, when I left Darwin, I stopped in Adelaide River at the campsite, and there was a half Dutch couple who recognized my car and then said, yeah, we have family living just below Broome, and you probably can stay there. And yeah, that's where I arrive now.
At Sylvester's place. Hi Sylvester.
Hey Jan.
So how did you end up here?
We're traveling around Australia for a year. Came here, found some work, we liked the place, so yeah, we ended up staying. Beautiful spot.
Okay, nice. And yeah, you grew up here kind of, hey?
Yeah, we've been here for about 14 years now.
So 40 years?
Yeah, wow. 14, okay. So that's good. Our kids grew up here, they've got their friends, so
yeah.
Nice part of Australia.
Yeah, you will never go back to home?
No, I don't think so. No, yeah. We love it too much here.
Yeah.
The climate and the surrounds, beautiful.
I'll be waiting up for heaven.
Hey mate, how are you?
Good, okay.
You recognize me?
Yes, yeah. I saw you on the news.
On the news? Wow, amazing. And you also know this electric car, yeah?
Yeah, I know it from, I saw you traveling the world.
Yeah, yeah.
Came from a long way.
So what you think about an electric car?
It's all right.
It's all right, yeah?
Okay, yeah.
That's good. So what you're doing here?
No, we just come with our school to spend a day here and go back to school.
Yep. That's good. Alright.
Didn't know who was gonna find you here in Points Cossake.
Yeah, I've been everywhere.
I should have my phone, I would have really took a picture.
Shit.
Counting every mile of railroad track that takes me back.
A few weeks ago I got a message from someone on Facebook, and he sent me a link to an article on ABC News. He said there's this couple in a tractor driving around Australia and raising money for a charity, I believe. So I thought, oh, that would be funny if I will bump into them. And yeah, it just happened. I saw them driving here on the streets. And I thought, hey, this is the famous tractor. Hi.
Yeah, so it's an Australian tractor. It was made in Australia, 1966 Chamberlain tractor. And it's a trekking tractor. So we're driving right around Australia.
Wow.
In the tractor, sitting on 40 kilometers an hour.
40 kilometers an hour. Okay.
So we've done 6,000 k so far in 3 months.
Yeah.
Traveling at 40 kilometers an hour.
Yeah.
And you're going all around Australia.
Going right around, and we're raising money for Make a Wish.
Ah, okay. Yeah, because normally on a picture I saw that you normally have something behind your tractor, right?
Yes, we have a colourful wagon that we tow. Chris made the wagon, and it's completely self. Contained, so it's got shower, toilet, air conditioner, TV, comfy bed.
Yeah.
And how are you raising money?
We're raising money by donations as we travel.
Yeah.
So online, and also shaking the tin. But if anyone wants to donate online, they can go in to give at Everyday Hero and put in tractor and wagon.
Okay. So why a tractor?
Because it's slow.
You like slow stuff, yeah?
Life's too fast. We had to slow down.
Okay.
Everyone needs to slow down in life. Yeah. It's too quick.
I wanted to tow the wagon with camels. And
the camels,
starting to learn how to train camels. And Chris just didn't want to do that.
No, it wasn't going to happen.
Yeah. And so what is the biggest challenge when traveling with a tractor?
The biggest challenge, probably letting the road trains pass, I suppose, the traffic, but they've been really good. Truckers have been great.
Okay.
Yeah, we know. Okay. No hassle at all.
And the other challenge is hearing each other. It's very noisy in the cabin, and we have to wear earphones.
Yeah, oh really?
Yeah, so Chris talks to the truckies over the headphones, like through the radio, and just lets them know that we're going to pull over or you know, they're right to go around or whatever. Yeah.
So what a struggle, a combustion engine.
Yeah,
yes, you should. You
your car was real quiet, we're really noisy.
Yeah, yes, very noisy.
Okay, so maybe next trip will be an electric tractor doing it around Australia.
That would be awesome if we could do
I know it exists. I saw one in Ukraine.
Really?
There were some guys who built their electric tractor.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes. Technology, it's amazing. It's awesome. Yes, right. We're going back in time with what we're doing in our travel, and you're going forward.
Yeah.
Recently, I was put in touch with Dwayne. Dwayne is currently promoting these hydro panels in Australia, and he said, mate, when you come to Karratha, I'll be happy to show you how this works, because I'm starting the first one in the Pilbara at the moment. Now, unfortunately, we couldn't make an appointment. We were both a bit hectic, but he said, just go there, see the product for yourself, and later when you get to Perth, I will explain you everything about this product. So this thing is called a hydro panel. Basically what this thing is doing is pulling vapor water from the air, and there is a filter system in here which then creates clean drinking water. I believe it creates about 5 liters a day with this setup, and over its lifespan of 15 years you will save up to 20,000 bottles of plastic water bottles, which is huge. Obviously this filter system is then powered by the solar panel, so this whole thing is completely self-sustainable, so you can drop this everywhere. So I'm guessing this will be used in communities which are far from, which are hard to reach, and where it's hard to create water or electricity, and then this will be like perfect solution. But when I get to Perth, I'm quite sure that Dwayne will tell me all the ins and outs of this great system. I am leaving Karratha today. My next host is a few 100 kilometers from here, so the coming days I need to survive a little bit. There's also Exmouth and Coral Bay and Monkey Maya, which is a beautiful part of Australia, so I really want to go there. It's a kind of far stretch, so today and tomorrow I need to get help from some roadhouses. There is one roadhouse, the Fortescue River Roadhouse, about 100k from here. I will try to fill my car up there so I can make it today even to the Nanatara Roadhouse. So then today I will cover about 300k. That's super convenient. Let's see if it works.
Big bummer here. Somewhere later in Perth I lost the memory card which I had in the DSLR camera, so I have none of this footage anymore. Luckily I shot some parts with my drone, so I try to tell you from the air how my trip went. From the roadhouse I made it to the Bulara station, who hosted me for a night. I made it to Exmouth, where I met a guy who was camping on a campsite, and I could plug in my car at his caravan and sleep on top of his car. What a cool experience. I then continued south and crashed at Coral Bay, where an employee of a resort let me charge and she invited me to come back to Exmouth. Together with her partner and another backpacker, we did a road trip through the national park, which was unbelievably beautiful. Oh, and here is the only shot of them, by the way. I stayed a night in Carnarvon at a really nice family, but unfortunately I have zero footage of this. In Northampton I was hosted by a very friendly family too. One of them was married to a Dutch lady, who was the one who heard about me, but unfortunately she was just on a trip back home. Nathan showed me his farm, and while he said it was a small one, I was pretty amazed by the extreme size of it. It's a cattle farm, and I killed herd of sheep with my drone, which was obviously good fun. I left Northampton, and in Geraldton I was hosted by the Geraldton's West, which was a really nice motel, and after that I stayed in Greenhead at a couple who took care of me for one night. On the 14th of August I arrived, with some struggles, at my cousin's place in Perth, who just had his birthday that day, but unfortunately from all these events the footage is lost. In the next video more about my interesting month in WA's capital, but this time with good video.